Right behind me, I have a box of agatized coral, but all of the coral pieces in here are pretty small. So we're gonna cut them on my 10-inch lapidary saw to see, is it worth cutting these little pieces open? Are they duds, or are they beautiful on the inside? We're gonna cut a lot today. So we cut through all these pieces to start with, and it didn't take too long, but some of them kind of fractured, showing some really nice signs. You can see some beautiful banding going on inside this agatized coral. Same with this one here. And it's very fragile, and I was giving it a lot of finesse because I know how delicate these pieces could be. And I was able to get through this one here, which I think is really unique, with no fracturing or anything. Oh, I haven't looked at this. This is the first time seeing this. That is so cool. Oh, you can see the bands right in there. Oh, that is gonna look great under UV light. And if you don't know, agatized coral reacts to UV light, showing a lot more hidden detail. So we'll be taking a peek at all these under UV light when we're all said and done. But let's take a peek at a few more of these. Oh, that's funny. Very, very interesting. Love the blacks and the blues in these. Oh, that's awesome. Beautiful white, blacks, blues. And this last one here. Interesting. I don't know. I haven't had too many with that kind of coloring in there. Very, very interesting. And I'm going to take my old shaker box here and throw all of our agatized coral pieces in there so we can hose it off when we're all said and done. There are so many pieces in here. So I would say so far it's totally worth cutting. They are fragile though when they're this small. Look at the details on this. That is so cool. I don't know if I'm gonna cut that. That one's actually pretty sweet. I'll leave that one aside, but we'll start cutting and showing you as we go here.
Whoa, whoa.
All right, I just stopped to show you this because inside this is a crystal pocket. It's an agatized coral geode, and majority of these are because they have open cavities inside, but this one has crystals on the inside. And I got excited because I was like, oh my gosh, black crystals, but the internals, the coloring is black, so it's causing these clear crystals because obviously right there it's white. These clear crystals look like black crystals, and I think that is amazing. It looks so, so cool. That's an awesome piece. This is one of my favorite ones so far, and we've had a lot of good ones. But I'm gonna start going to town on a ton of these, and I will show you how they all turn out, good and bad, when we're done. So we cut through a lot of these, and this is where we started. We cut all the way through and ended on these, and I gotta say, the last one was hands down my favorite. It's got this weird orange stuff inside. Once we clean that up, that should come off. It'll be blues, whites, super, super cool. It was probably more bad in this one. A lot of ones that were just kind of gunky, some that broke up a lot, not a lot going on. Literally just looks like clay. You know, like powder packed together. A couple really nice ones, but this one is pretty cool. I'd say out of, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. I'd say 5.5 were good ones, so a little less than 50-50. Definitely excited to get all these hosed off at the end, especially this one too. This one, I think this will look pretty sweet. So one of the things that I've learned from cutting all this agatized coral today is that when you have pieces that are very light, they end up being what we would call more duds. And all of these right here are heavy. They're a lot heavier than the rest of them. So I'm hoping that all these are the higher quality pieces. And this is the last bunch that we're gonna cut before we clean the rest off and look at them under UV light. But the last piece that we're gonna cut is this super long coral finger. And I'm gonna see if I can cut it in one straight line without any fracturing or anything break off. So that's the last thing we're gonna cut. And yeah, we'll see. We'll see. I am gonna move on to this last cut, this super long piece. It's straight enough to get a solid cut, but I think right in through here could fracture, and then down in here could, especially right there, it's gonna be interesting. I'm gonna say I can't do it, but we'll try.
Oh, dang it. That would have been sweet. So close.
Not really. You got a little pushed on me there. Got caught right in that thin part, like I said. But this piece is full. It just looks kind of funny. That coloring in there, that is really, really beautiful. I should show you. That coloring up here is really, really beautiful. Well, kind of got it, but not really. Let's go hose these off. I know from the past that a lot of these are going to show up some really beautiful details when we hit it with UV light. This is one of the last ones we cut. It's like pure black. I think this one is going to be magnificent under UV light. This one, I'm going to set right here. I bet that's a complete loss. I bet there's nothing going on with that. But oh, these are so fun to cut open. So I'm going to leave all these right here. And we're gonna wait for the sun to go down, and then we'll come out with a UV light and we'll hit them and we'll show off even more beautiful details. For me, it's gonna be a few hours. For you, it'll be a second. Got my UV light here. Just gonna see if it's working in my yard. Yep. So it is night out and we have our agatized coral being hit with one UV light up here on my left. And then in my right hand, I have my big Convoy C8. UV light right here. Some of these are really, really popping, and I'm gonna show you them. Like this guy right here. Really, really cool agate band showing up on the outside right here. That is super cool. This guy right here, which is one of my favorites. Really, really cool details showing up right over here. A lot of these are this guy right here. This is that one that had that pure black face. Look at that. Isn't that just unbelievable? This is completely black with that little pocket right there. And then the other side of it is right here. Oh, I do not get tired of looking at that. That is so neat. Let's see if I can find some more here that are really cool. Really, majority of these are really, really beautiful. Got those hidden agate bands going on the inside. And that one that I said, I bet nothing's going on. I was right. Nothing's going on. That's this piece right here. This one, this is really, really beautiful. Up in here, so cool. Look at how detailed those agate bands are. Fantastic. We'll show one more here. This one's pretty special. So cool. Crazy. Those were not there before. Those beautiful agate band details right along here. So neat.
So I'm back inside, and I gotta say, I do think those little agatized coral pieces are worth cutting open. There's just more of a chance of getting a few duds in there, but when you put them under UV light, a majority of them are still amazing, and I always have so much fun exposing all those hidden details inside that agatized coral. And I had a ton of fun putting this whole video together. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, leave a thumbs up, leave a comment, let me know what you thought, and if you're new, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Thank you all so much for watching. We'll see you next time. Bye.